Hey guys, okay, so this is going to be my video about my new doctor and just going over my appointment that I had with him. He is a reproductive endocrinologist at a fertility doctor's office, so he really knows what he's talking about. He quit his job when him and his wife were going through fertility stuff and decided that he wanted to be a doctor to help people get through all kinds of fertility stuff. So he's been where we are and he's gone through all this stuff and he wanted to help couples get through it as well. So I met with him on January 4th and I was at the office for about an hour, and I talked with him for about 40 minutes. And then he did an internal sonogram, and then we went back to his office, and he explained every picture of everything that he took while we were doing the sonogram, and then we went over what our options are, and then I went on my way. So these, like, look at this, front and back pages. These are notes that he took and gave to me. So that's something, like, I was really impressed by that. Like, while he was, like, writing stuff down, I was kind of like, why is he writing all this stuff down? But then he gave it to me, and he was like, you can have this. But, like, he was telling me all kinds of different things that I have and don't have, and was like, he drew me this little picture he drew is, like, of my uterus, and was explaining to me, like, this little diagram is, like, that one is about, like, what's going on in my body, like, why I need the metformin, and how it's not, like, my body doesn't, like, do insulin properly, but I'm not diabetic, which my last doctor did the glucose test to make sure that I wasn't diabetic, so I'm not diabetic. So then, like, this side, which, no, that is not a picture of a penis. Rick thought that it was when I brought this home. That he was, like, showing me, like, how they, something that they do for, like, IUI, what they put the sperm in once it's, like, concentrated or something. So, okay, he, said that he thinks that, if we just tried on our own 4 years from now, we have less than a 40% chance of being pregnant, which is really sad, but, you know, it is what it is. That's kind of my attitude now. Like, in December, I was like, I don't want to do injections. I don't want to do any of this stuff. I don't want to have to think about IVF and how many eggs would we transfer and how many would we freeze and what do we do with the leftover ones if we don't use them. I just didn't want to have to face all that stuff. But meeting with this doctor was like, okay, this is where we're at. People do this every day, so suck it up and get through it. Like, this is just part of life. And, you know, whether you want to do it or you don't want to do it, it's where you're at. So, you know, take it. And then he said that if we did Clomid, which we've already done the two rounds, he said that it would take 8 to 9 cycles before my body responded well enough for me to possibly get pregnant. And he was like, you've already done two, which you didn't respond very well. And your first two kind of tell you how things are going to go, which I didn't know that. I knew that, like, your first one was okay, your second one was better, and your third one was your best. And then after that, it kind of, I don't know, trickles off or whatever. So he said that if it doesn't work in your first two rounds, you're kind of like, if you're not really, if you didn't respond really well, then even if you didn't get pregnant, if you didn't respond really well, then move on. Like, you're just going to waste time. So it was kind of nice for him to, like, be that blunt with me. Like, cause I thought, like, well, let's just keep trying Clomid. And he's like, no, it's wasting your time. Like, that's not what we're here for. He was like, my job is to get you a take home baby. That's what I'm here for. And I don't think Clomid's going to do it for you. He said I would need 8 to 9 cycles of Clomid, which they really don't like you to do more than 6 because it's, I don't know, something with, like, causing cancer, something. So then he said my next option was doing the injectables, and he explained to me, like, the, sorry, Tyson's playing. he explained to me, like, the side effects of the injections and, that, like, the chances of twins, the chances of triplets, and, he said that he was one of the doctors that they called. He was like, you know the show Kate Plus Eight? I was like, yeah. He was like, well, I was one of the doctors that they called once they realized how many of those babies stuck. And, he was like, you know, there's something wrong with all but one of those babies. And, they just do a really good job on camera. And I will not make you Kate Plus Eight. I will not make you Octomom. That was a major misuse of medications. And I don't do that. My job is to get you a take-home baby, not eight babies at once. That's not healthy for you. That's not healthy for the babies. And I won't do it. So that was really good because Rick was like, Rick is really scared that if we have to do a lot of fertility treatment that we're going to end up with, like, multiple children with a lot of, like, special needs because we were so selfish just wanting babies. So, he said that he thinks that if we do injectables and if we maybe have to throw in an IUI there, it would take maybe 2 to 3 cycles of that. So this is our first cycle. So that's kind of why I'm thinking, like, this is just like a practice round. It may take another round of this. It may take 2 more rounds of this. And then he said that the last option is IVF, which I think he could tell, like, by my face. I was kind of like, ugh, IVF, scary. But he explained to me the process of IVF and, like, the different medications that you have to do. And he said that it's, like, he thinks that that is, like, obviously the most successful because they're in such control of every step of the way. And he said that he thinks that our first transfer would be successful. So I talked it over with Rick and explained to him, like, everything the doctor said. And I went back the next day for the financial meeting, and the girl explained everything to me. What our insurance covers, what it doesn't cover, what we will have to pay out of pocket, and all that stuff. And I came home and talked to Rick about it, and Rick's big thing was like, okay, but if we do injectables, like 2 to 3 rounds of that, and if we do an IUI, and then those for some reason don't work, and then we have to do IVF, like, all the money we spent on the rounds of injectables, we could have just put that money towards IVF, which is totally true. But I just feel like, just give me a chance with the injectables. Let me just see if I respond to it. And if I don't respond to it at all, then let's move forward. But I just want to see, like, if there is a possibility of it working, then let's try that first. And the doctor said, when he could tell that when he said IVF, I was kind of like, ugh. He was like, you know, IVF right now is a bullet we can leave in the gun, I think. Which I was really glad that he said that because I didn't want to feel like, you know, this is an infertility clinic. They do IVF very regularly. So I didn't want him to just be like, just do IVF. Like, I didn't want them to, like, push me into doing that if I don't have to do that yet. So our plan, we decided we were going to do 3 rounds of injectables, and if by the 3rd round we're not pregnant, the 3rd round we're going to do injectables with an IUI, and then if we're not pregnant by that one, then we're going to go to IVF. So that's our plan. The doctor said that unless there's something else wrong that he doesn't see yet, then he thinks we would be able to get 16 to 35 eggs on our IVF retrieval and that the first transfer would be successful. So that's really good. And every time that I've gone in, he has seemed really positive, really hopeful, and, you know, on the ball, down to earth. And, you know, this is his job. Seeing girls like me is his job all day, every day. That's what he does. So I feel like I'm at the right place. I feel like I'm in the right hands. He knows what it's like to be where we're at. And I just feel really good about him. And I feel like he is part of God's plan for us. Like, he was the doctor that I needed to be going to. And we My last doctor had told us that before she would let us do any Clomid rounds, that we had to have a semen analysis done. Well, then when they called me and said that we were going to start Clomid, she never said anything about the semen analysis. So in the middle of our second round, like when I was like in the middle of AF on our second round, I was like, well, what about the semen analysis? Because I don't want to spend 4 months of Clomid and then find out that, like, it was a waste because there's something wrong on Rick's end, too. And she was like, oh, okay, yeah, we will do a semen analysis. So we did that, and we got the results back, which I kind of wish that I knew more about the results. All that they told me was that the results were good and that his count, I think they said that a normal count is, like, 20 million is the lowest they like to see it, and his was 39 million, I think. So, but that's all I know. Like, I thought there was supposed to be, like morphology and motility, mobility, all this stuff. And I know that some of that you have to learn, like, in the post-coital thing, like, whatever. But I just thought that it would be, like, more, I don't know, I thought I would learn more from it, but, so, it's nice to know that, like, 100% of the issues are on my end, but then, like, December, I felt, like, really guilty. Like, wow, it's all on me. It's all my issue. But, whatever, you know, that's where we are. That's part of being married, is, like, sticking together through everything that life brings you, and this is what life has brought us. So, this is where we're at, and we're facing it head on, and we're going to conquer it. We're going to conquer infertility, and we're going to have a baby, probably more than one, and it's going to be awesome. So that is all of the stuff on my new doctor, and I'm really impressed with him. And if you guys are interested in learning about them, I think their website is like www.haveababy.com or tohaveababy.com or something, but it's the Share Institute for Reproductive Medicine, SIRM, and I'm in Central Illinois, and they have more than one location, though. They have one in Las Vegas, they have one in Missouri, they have one, I don't remember where else, but they have more than one location. And if you guys are, like, within, like, a good radius of Central Illinois, meet with them, because they're so knowledgeable and they're so helpful and so hopeful, and they work with you, like, budget. If you have to pay cash, or if you're, like, paying 100% out of pocket, they have discounted rates, and they work with insurances, and it's just really, like, and the consultation and the financial consultation were both free. So that was really awesome. That, like, this, all of this, and that doctor's time, and that sonogram, and then going back the next day and learning, like, what we would pay and all that stuff, that was all free, which I thought was, like, awesome customer service. Like, to give me your time like that when you are, like, so busy and so, like, in demand, and then, like, you gave me your time for free. Like, that I thought was really awesome. So I was impressed, and I would really recommend them, their practice, to anybody. And if you guys have any questions, leave a comment or send me a private message or anything like that, because I would be more than happy to talk to you. And that doctor gave me his email, and he was like, email me anytime, day or night. I have this email address. It comes to my work, and it goes to my home computer, and it goes to my phone, and I, answer it as soon as I can. I will respond to you within 24 hours, and, you know, any question that you have, just ask. There's no stupid question. The only stupid question is one that you leave unasked. So I was just really impressed with them, and it really gave me new hope. My last doctor didn't give me hope at all. And this guy made it seem like, you know, this is a quick fix. We're gonna get you where you need to be, and whatever it takes is what we're gonna do. And, you know, he made it sound like Like, he's just so knowledgeable. And that's what I was lacking with my last doctor. She just seemed so scared to attempt anything. And she didn't know a lot about fertility and fertility drugs. So.